Assalamu alaikum, Sayyidi.
Walaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
Thank you for mentioning the protests on campus. How can we stay safe in our extracurriculars and on campus jobs? Shukran, Sayyidi.
Walaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Alhamdulillah, then don't protest. You should be safe. Go to your class, go home, do your work, live your life, go out and feed and help people. When we think that things are not good and people are not acting right, then we have to act correctly in every aspect. That when we talked about everyone is an oppressor, why only focus on one person or other people, why we don't look to ourselves? And Allah is going to call us. And human nature, as soon as somebody says, oh, we're going to call you for crimes, everybody becomes scared. They think that what they do is in a vacuum and nobody sees. Allah sees everything. Those whom have faith in every aspect of their life, they have to fear Allah, fear disappointing Allah, and fear Allah's punishment. And within our own environment, our own lives, people have anger. And anytime somebody has anger, they have to make wudu, pray two rakah salatul wudu, and excuse themselves from people. If your day is not good, your character is not right, something in your mind just not appropriate, you're not feeling straight, the training is that you have to keep yourself in wudu and then avoid people. Otherwise you unleash your anger upon other people. And the tariqah comes and teaches, not one person, their heart should have been affected by you in a bad way. Some people try to say they represent the shaykh, they yell at people, insult people, ridicule people.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nur John. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. Inshallah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
And you're going to be brought to a council of crime. Don't look, oh, it's only on the news. No, people do it within their spiritual path. That they're angry all the time, and if they feel they have a little authority, they inflict their anger upon everyone. So we watch TV, so oh, those people, we see this everywhere we go, amongst every people, every community, every action in our lives. And especially for those whom are in the schools of tariqah and in the presence of the shaykhs, we said that if you commit a crime anywhere on earth, it has a sin, one sayat. If you commit that crime in Mecca, it's 1,000,000 sayat. That's why it's called haramain, no haram. Prophet warned, don't do your crime here, it will be multiplied. Medina, that's 100,000. We say it would be 10 million if Kaaba is 1 million, and definitely in the presence of Prophet ﷺ, is enormous. Now imagine Zawiya, where this is the place of the shaykh, this is the living realities of a Kaaba, everything is the same. Means the sins of people are multiplied and they're held to a much higher standard, and therefore Allah will be very angered. So anyone who deems themselves to have some authority and can be illusional and delusional from themselves, that the shaykh never even said you have an authority. And with that authority they want to be angry, abusive, yell at people, yell at children, young men. It's completely unacceptable. You're no better than those people who should be brought to war criminals. Don't use the tariqah to hurt people. Don't use any authority to block people from Allah's rahmah and mercy. So when we see these things out and then we hear these things inside, it's horrific. The tariqahs are supposed to be the examples of rahmah and mercy, in which people come for a sanctuary, they experience the zikrs and the teachings, follow the example of the shaykh. That everybody tunes in on their difficult days and on their busy days, and they had a tough week at work, and the energy is very heavy when people log on, they're knocking me out. Because people, the condition of their hearts are sad, stressed, have difficulty, they can't pay their bills, they don't know what's coming for the future. And the role of the shaykh is, and the role that we inherit from Prophet ﷺ, is keep the way of rahmah and mercy. That we are the representatives of rahmatan lil alameen, that give people hope. Encourage people through good character and good manners. So never is somebody with bad manners a representative of the shaykh. And they're failing at every type of representation. And this is not the way of Allah, and this is not the way of Sayyidina Muhammad. And this was throughout our lives. We would go visit the Zawiya in London, go down to eat. And an old lady, angry as heck, if you wanted to go and get something to eat for breakfast, she would take a hard-boiled egg and throw it at you. She was such an angry person, and she thought she was representing the shaykh. So you would get your food and hide, because this lady for some reason in the cafeteria was throwing an egg at people, and she thought this is the good way. And so many times the shaykh would come down and say, you have to be kind to, these are the guests of Allah. But we saw it all our lives, that angry people do angry things. And there was another one who was a French guy, that as soon as Mawlana would give him like keys, he became Sahib al-Miftah, the owner of keys, like Allah had given all the keys of paradise to this man. And now all he did was lock the bathrooms. Can you imagine that Allah give you some authority? And the only thing you can do with that authority is you lock the washing facilities for wudu. Nobody could go make wudu without going to his bab. Go to his door, please, unlock this for the… No. Why? You're going to make a mess. And then we would go back to Mawlana, what this crazy person is doing. With this one key, you didn't give him the key even of authority. You gave him the lowest possible key, the janitorial key. And with that he's still going to oppress everybody. We would run out and go outside of the farm and then have to everybody make wudu somewhere else, just to avoid that man's character. He's not in tariqah. I can't imagine if anyone has ever heard of him again. So that's not how it operates. It operates when the shaykh gives you the key of every door imaginable and nobody even knows you have it and you never use it. And all that you do is try to be a mercy to people. Not to have anything, nothing, and pretend like you have everything and you harm people. So this is a sadness when we hear oppression outside and everybody wants to protest and everybody wants to come against it, but in reality Allah said, why change the condition of anyone? if they don't want to change themselves. The collective whole of people becomes nasty and dirty for what? The tariqas have to be the example of good character, rahmah and mercy. And every night to fear, Ya Rabbi, did I harm somebody's heart in my actions, my gestures, my demeanor, in any type of advice I gave. If the person's not of a sound mind, that's something else, because they don't understand what they're doing and you have to move them aside for the safety and the danger of other people. But in every other aspect of our lives, it's a continuous consciousness with Allah, that to be very conscious, every night go home with an accounting, did I overstep my authority, did I hurt anyone, harm anyone, did I send anyone home crying because I talked in an inappropriate way. So this is a horrible time to be an oppressor and to see oppression outside and then to hear from people that there's oppression inside. We pray that people take the tariqahs serious and take their responsibilities serious and to have a consciousness that Allah's watching and Prophet is watching, and that this is a time in which to be under Allah's rahmah and not Allah's anger. That anyone whom runs away because of you, you carry all their burdens and all they should have achieved, and now that they won't achieve, all of that sayat is thrown upon your head. So that's not something that people should encourage to carry that, but we're here to encourage people to have hope. Come to Allah's rahmah, come to the love of Sayyidina Muhammad and come to the abode of safety. And these are the oases of safety and mercy. So people have a stressful day, a stressful week, they turn on, they hear the voice of the shaykh and they're reassured, everything's gonna be okay. When you see something bad, stay away. Take a completely different area and don't even walk through in that direction. You can become the victim of a ricochet of oppression. Oppression is if something was meant to be coming towards somebody but it bounces off and hit you in the head, that you don't even want to be in the vicinity of any type of oppression and bad character. Then go out and do good deeds and good actions and exhibit hope and kindness for humanity to be under Allah's rahmah and mercy, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, what role does intuition play in the activation of the third eye, and how can one distinguish between spiritual visions and mere imagination?
I don't know, I saw somebody made one of the anime of the third eye, it looked like Dajjal. So if you don't know what you're trying to make for artwork, please don't do it. So when we talk about Ahlul Basira, this is a heavenly station, and there was some horrific looking thing with Dajjal writings on a face, on a head and an eye, and it was just, well, I don't know what that was. We mention third eye because this is their understanding. This Western world calls the eye of vision, spiritual vision, a third eye, but Islamic realities is that your heart is open and that you see with the eye of your soul, and this is the importance. So that the people whom train to be nothing, they have the connection with the shaykh, not with the jinn. So we've described this many times, you can go back if you're new, then go back into our videos of what is seeing and what is accompanying a shaykh. Many new age people, somehow they did something and they're now attached to jinn. And they say, oh shaykh, my spirit guide shows me this, shows me that. I say, we don't accept any of that. There's no spirit guide, you're talking and telling me you're possessed when you talk like this. Tariqah comes and teaches the discipline of sitting, meditating, connecting with the shaykh, visualize that shaykh that you know, you hear, you watch, you understand, and ask for their spiritual presence to be with you. And if you are possessed and if you are using these types of nefarious creatures for your whimsical spiritual belief, the shaykh's presence is going to burn that. You're going to feel burning, you're going to feel pain, you're going to feel disruption, because something has attached itself to you and now you're asking from Allah's haqq. Means from the light of Prophet that the shaykhs are the recipients of that reality, that they come and they facilitate and bring the light of Prophet. And immediately the person start to get headache, feel pain, feel discomfort, because that's a cleansing. So that was the system. You have to make a connection with the shaykh. The shaykh has to discipline you on this way of muraqabah. So don't think that I understand meditation until you've read our way of meditation. It's not the new age meditation, it's not from what people think of meditation. It's very much accompanying a guide, and as a result of visualizing the shaykh, feeling the energy of the shaykh, and continuously making an accounting of yourself with the shaykh, that what did I do, what did I say, what were my actions. If you truly have a strong connection with the shaykh, then everything becomes corrected, because at night as soon as you again go back into your connection, they reprimand you for everything you did. That, what was that? What did you say? How did you overstep yourself? But when you don't have a connection with the shaykh and you're imagining you have a connection with the shaykh, yeah, and then you imagine you have connection with every spiritual being, it's just imagination. The connection with the shaykh is a strong discipline, and they exhibit, we said before, the people whom have a strong connection with the shaykh, they exhibit these beatific characteristics. You don't exhibit harsh characteristics and go and try to convince people that you have a strong connection with the shaykh. You have to have a beatific characteristic, soft, very kind, very loving. Everything that the shaykh is describing. Means imagine that the shaykh is talking to you and he's just completely angry and just horrible at all times. So how is he describing these beatific realities? So then the true connection and the true ones whom are connected, they should exhibit the beatific character. When you see somebody not exhibiting beatific character, it is a self-evidence that they're not connected, that this is not the correct way, and that they're doing something with their nafs and making illusions for themselves. So tariqah comes with very strong discipline, especially in the Western world, because our guidance is different than people from the East. They come here and they say something, they're incorrect, and they go back home. But in the West we have a completely different audience, and this audience, they have an understanding of meditation and spirituality that's all jinn related. All jinn related. Everywhere they go they burn fragrances to attract the jinn. Everything they say of their kumbaya, their breathing, their kundalini, everything they do is a jinn-based meditation. If they go to Reiki, these are Japanese jinn-based, the other one Chinese jinn-based, and the worst of them Hindu jinn-based. All of them. That's how they bring energy, because they don't have, we said before, there's just one key into the heavens. Its phrase is, La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah, the rope drops. And you can catch it. So when they say, shaykh, is this connected, is that connected? No, they have no connection. As a result of no connection to heavenly energy, then who do you think they're using? The jinn. Recite this, do like this, the jinn will give its favor, because it wants to be worshipped, it wants to be called. And Allah says in the Qur'an, how many of them have you taken as your Lord, your authority and your savior, and that they would save you. So nothing has changed, this is the same. Biggest now in the West is that system. They think they can just call upon what they want and get the favors of what they want, and there's no accountability. So tariqah is strong in these regions to teach them. You have to have the heavenly connection, and that through discipline, good character, good actions, put your clothes on, put yourself together, walk straight, do everything with a discipline so that Allah will open that reality for the servant, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
We suffer a lot because of mentally disabled brother. He insults us daily, he's always extremely angry, and he no longer respects any hygiene rules. What can we do? Thank you, Sayyidi.
Yeah, if you, I don't know how old you are and what type of help you can get, that people like that, they need help. So they have to be in a place where they can receive help and not to become destructive on other people. So at whatever position or point you can in life, you get your work, your life and get out. Because that type of situation just going to bring a lot of difficulty and a lot of hardship. So inshaAllah Allah help you, save you and free you from any type of oppression, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Is Imam Mahdi alayhi salam the master of the wave reality of our time?
Yes, sahib al-zaman. We're saying he's the owner of the time. Sahib al-imdad means that at every time there's an authority. So like we said before, that if people want power from Allah, the Creator, God Almighty, they have to go to the door of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the concept of real tawheed in the world of malakut, means oneness. There must be one door, one nucleus in which emanates all power. That is the reality of La ilaha illallah, then that door is Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From the heart of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then it must have a flowing power coming out. So that flowing power is to be given to Imam Mahdi salam, so that everyone in the spiritual realm for this area must receive a faiz from Sahib al-Waqt. So any shaykh is a shaykh with his worth, then he has to have a connection to Sayyidina Mahdi salam, because that is the power source. So for us to even understand this, imagine there's one power facility in this whole world. If you're not connected to that power, where are you drawing your power from? Say, oh, from this and from that. No, all those power sources have all stopped. All of those shaykhs have all stopped. Everything has been transferred to Imam Ali salam, from Imam Ali salam to his grandson, Sahib al-Waqt, Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdi salam. So that is the Sahib al-Imdad, the one whom is giving all support. And that's why the manners, the character, the beatific actions, everything has to match. If somebody talks against Sayyidina Mahdi alayhi salam, absolutely that person is abtar, is cut, takes nothing, he has no power from anything. If anyone's supporting him, then maybe the jinn and the ifrit. But again, the system has to be understood, because to our mind it's very logical. If Allah says that everything is based on adab, you want power, you want the connection, love Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Could you not love and Allah send you power? No, because why would he do that? Then he would be encouraging not to love Prophet ﷺ, saying, okay, you can no pick and choose. Allah says, no, you don't pick and choose. If you want Divinely rope of power, you have to go to the door of Muhammadun Rasulullah ﷺ. That's why we said before was the illusion. We said, oh, what about this one? They seem to all be so similar. None of them are similar now. They came and they took men for gods. So now that rope became very clear. Oh, now I see clearly now. I can see clearly now the rope to Allah is Muhammadun Rasulullah. And that's why Prophet ﷺ described that in the last days that rope would come very close to humanity. And these were the awliya, these are the ulul amri minkum. So who then is the head of ulul amri minkum? Is Imam Ali ﷺ. And his grandson is the foretold personality that Muslims should be waiting for, which is Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mahdi ﷺ. And as a result of connecting their heart, having good manners, having good character, they should be receiving that faiz. And you can go back to the talks on the six powers of the heart. That's why the book was released, that these six powers describes how the people of tafakkur connect. As a result of how they connect, they receive the faiz from the holy faces. So this is a system, this is the power grid of the heavens. When they don't talk respectfully, they are cut from that power grid. So then people would wonder, where is that person getting their power from? And it's not from the heavens. That's why we said then those people who sold the religion, they speak very badly about Sayyidina Mahdi salam. So that's again that system of munafiqeen. And that they sold their deen and their religion. So these are the times in which to have good character and to keep that connection and to build the connection with the shaykhs and to build the connection with Sayyidina Mahdi salam, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, for students who seek to become of the liquid state, what is the path of least resistance that they can take to make it as painless as possible?
There's no pain, no gain. Means that to be solid in your matter and to achieve liquid is the most difficult. From liquid to gas is easy because you've already been melted. But for people whom are coming in three states, in a solid state, everyone comes solid. And what they think, what they know, what they understand, and to keep the company of the shaykh, to do their tafakkur and to meditate and contemplate is what? Is to be burned by their light. So that their light keep burning and burning and burning, and when you're wet, you like it, you think it's fantastic, but when you've been in around a while and you dried out, it's becoming intense, it becomes heated, becomes lots of energy. That's the most important part, is that to continue when it's heated, continue when the fire of the nazar is upon you and you feel yourself burning. And you tied yourself so that you can't run. You've given everything, you've done everything, so where are you going to run and restart the whole thing? And that was the concept that we described. That's why the shaykhs, they operate differently than other people. They encourage you to support. Why? So you can't run. We said the Algerian shaykh, the lion of the desert, said what? He knows that the tanks are coming. He didn't tell the students. He said, come here with me. He said, why? Take this rope, tie on your feet. Tie on your feet. Tie. And all the students tied their legs to the shaykh's legs behind the sand dune. Then he said, we're all tied? He said, yes. Okay, now lift your head. They lifted over the sand dune and they said, oh, the French tanks are coming. They're all just lined up. And they all looked at the shaykh and said, yeah, where are you going to go? Either we're going to face that or we go heaven together. So he said, okay, alhamdulillah, undefeated. Undefeated. Why? Because Allah's with them. But this was a system for everyone in tariqah, because the greatest fight is the fight against one's devil. That as soon as they see their devil, they're going to run. If you don't tie them into the system, their nafs will say, let's run from this guy, he's very tough, let's go to that guy, the one who's far away and we don't ever have to ask him any questions, he doesn't really participate in our lives, but we can say we're in tariqah. Then they try to fool their nafs and run. And the tariqah comes and the shaykhs of this reality teach, no, no, you have so much into the game, you're not going to start this over again. And you've tied yourself to their foot And as a result, the burning comes, the difficulties come, the testings come, the character, and you begin to emit all of these bad characters that have to be burned. There's things within us we don't know exist until Allah bring them out. So that you don't bring it out in the grave, but you bring it out in while you're alive. You know, you think you have something until you come to a group of people and you react and act differently and you say, I don't know why I'm feeling like this, I'm feeling like that. And that's exactly what is needed to know. All these different characteristics, and the person who meditates begins to sense it and feel it. And when they begin to come against those characteristics, they're now becoming liquid. And in the end they say, oh, I fought for so many years, I really just don't care, whatever. We go here, this happened, we go there, that happened, just stay quiet and it's finished. And when they become liquid and they have that liquid state where they're very soft, very kind, they don't talk, they just whatever happens, happens, they hide themselves. Then again in their muraqabah the shaykhan turned them into gas instantly, in which they hit with energy and they become ethereal. They leave the physical body and their spiritual experiences are experiencing through their soul. This is what Allah wants from us, not a physical experience but to have our ethereal and a reality through our soul while we're on this earth. And this is like death before death, that you died from all your comments and all the thoughts and what you have in your mind. And all of that you left, and all that you have now is just the heart that's submitting and feeling and being dressed by these realities, inshaAllah. Those people achieve wave realities, right? Because every time they enter into an ethereal state, like a gas, their liquid state immediately gets heated and they can go. They experience the knowledges through the vibrations. They achieve the knowledges from the vibrations, their soul can be sent into the presence of the shaykh, into the soul of the shaykh, and they retrieve the knowledges at a much deeper reality. And we described before that the jinn are wave creatures. So who's most disturbed by men whom leave particles to become waves? They're wave reality. So they have a command of this game as long as you remain a particle, because they're flying around, moving around, entering into everyone, making all sorts of mischief and nobody knows what's happening. This is the way they love the game to be played. So they have every motive, because you always ask, what's the motive, Shaykh? Well, they have every motive for you not to be a wave, then you don't know what they're doing. You don't know how they're abusing and how they're taking and how they're feeding off of the energy of this creation. So then the tariqas are coming and teaching and have always taught, no, no, go back to your wave. And as soon as you train and become ethereal, what happens? You're sensing them. What are you doing? Why is your energy coming in now? What's happening? And your energy, since you now operate through your energy, your energy is more like a weapon against shaitan, because as your energy is moving, it's moving with an angelic frequency. As soon as your energy starts to go after them, it's burning and destroying them, because they're an energy too. All they needed is for you to meet them on an energy plane. My particle can't do nothing. But as soon as you're a wave and your energy is around and you're sensing negative energy, but your energy is at a frequency that they're not at, they're at a very low frequency, they don't have angelic realities and angelic frequencies. So then the student whom achieves these wave realities, and then Allah is giving to them zikrs. We said before, when they make the zikr of who, they in their wave reality, it's a fierce energy that's coming out. That energy crushes and destroys. When Allah says, قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقِّ, the say to this ignorance that when the truth comes, falsehood perishes, and falsehood by its nature is always perishing, zahukan. This is from an eternal ayatul kareem in the world of light. It's not only the truth and falsehood of the physical, Allah doesn't care for physical. But this is an immense power in the spiritual realm, that if you fill yourself with the light of haqq, how falsehood going to be in the presence of the light of haqq? It begins to chase after the falsehood and is zahukan and destroys it. So no, these nefarious creatures have no interest that people reach their wave potential, achieve wave realities for to receive knowledges, the powers of zikrs and the reality of zikr. We are not at the reality of zikr, we are just doing imitated zikrs. When Allah grant the servant a wave reality, Allah grants the reality of the dhikr. Every time they say, Bismillah Rahmanir Rahim, everything shakes within them. It's something that can't be imagined. When Allah opened the reality of their dhikr, every dhikr they're making is a vibration and strength, so that everything around them is shaking with their zikr. You can't put a weight on Allah's words. We say, Bismillah Rahmanir Rahim, we're imitating, nothing happening. But when we enter into a wave state, and this is through their seclusions, but now this world is going to be a seclusion. If Allah wants to open for His servants whom trained, a day will come and Allah will say, Bismillah is open for you. Every dhikr they make, their entire being shakes. They can shake the building, they can shake anything in their vicinity just by their dhikr. And the light of their energy coming out and going after everything. So shaitan knows this reality and he fears that reality. So then keep them dumb, and that's the whole system, is keep everybody dumb, give them bad things to eat, put on petroleum products for clothes, and these people will never reach anything. But they plan, Allah's plan is better. So alhamdulillah, InshaAllah Allah opened these realities for sincere servants inshaAllah, for all of us inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Yesterday your respected presence had mentioned the third eye and moral excellence from the upper point of the triangle. How do we unlock the secrets of enlightenment from the secrets of the star? And is this the only And is this only for the 313 awliya of the heavenly Muhammadan government?
No, but they're the ones whom hold that reality. That the 313 whom Allah granted from out of 124,000 awliya, 313 are inheriting the ability to deliver a message, because the star reality within them was given and opened. They opened the upper reality, which is the power of their soul, said that their Islam is based on knowledge. That's the reality of their Islam. As a result of the knowledges, then their heart and faith is based on love and illumination. And as a result, again they call third eye, we say the station of moral excellence, which illuminates the head and the forehead, is the station of moral excellence. Their conduct and character is of the heavenly character. As a result, their soul, Allah opened the power and authority of their soul. And their soul then governs the lower triangle of the body, which is what? The people who walk the earth, they don't have knowledge, because they denying the realities of Islam. So what they have on the right side is ignorance. Then on their heart they don't have illumination and light, they have anger. And the lower part of their body is fire. So they're ignorant, angry, and their lower body's fiery. That's why you see everybody is just doing horrific things with their body. And they don't care anymore, they have no shyness anymore, they don't even know who their father and their mother is, because they're just governing their life by fire. So ignorant, angry, fiery people, they walk the earth, 99.9% of people. That's why the system of these awliya that Allah enact and activated, this 313, that they carry this reality. They carry the reality of the 3 points up, 3 points down, and the sultanate upon the throne. And as a result, when they begin to teach that haqqaiq, then people have to open the power of their soul. Only by opening the power of their soul, what happens? Your knowledge will lock the lower triangle and take away ignorance. Only these teachings take away ignorance. Then your illumination in your heart and the light and love of faith, when you have love and faith, what does it do? It takes away anger. That's why I say, can't be an angry person and say that I follow a shaykh. You're not supposed to be angry. You never should exhibit that anger. If you are angry, go home, take a shower and hide yourself. But never bring that anger out into public, because it means then there's lack of light and faith. So light and faith push anger out, and as a result now their soul is governing their body. And their illumination is putting out the fire of bad desires and the fire of the character. So what happens now? They become a star. So they're walking stars upon this earth. And that's when Prophet described his holy companions, that follow any of my companions, they are like a najm, they are stars on a dark night. Ya ayyuhal mushtaghuna bi nuri jamalihi muttajuna shafa'atuhu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslim. Means there is even a salawat of najm, that when we recite that salawat, the reality of the star of Prophet ﷺ, the star maker of Prophet ﷺ, to make us into that reality. Ya ayyuhal mushtaquna bi nuri jamalihi wal muttajuna shafa'atuhu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi wa alihi. So means that salawat, it makes from the star maker that reality for the servant to become a star, in which their soul governs their reality, and the soul dresses the physicality and disciplines the physicality, inshaAllah.
Sayyidi, we have a thank you message from a member. As-salamu alaykum ya Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Listening to you brings so much peace to my aching heart. You answer the questions which I can't even put in words. Ya Sayyidi, Jazakallah Khair. Thank you for everything.
Allah bless you. Alhamdulillah. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum Ya Sayyidi.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
What is the reality of the plasma state in relation to the four states of matter and awliya?
I don't know, four plates. Plasma state? We know three states, solid, liquid, gas. So plasma we're not familiar with, unless that's something new that science is saying.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
How do you navigate feelings of guilt, shame or remorse when confronting the oppression done to our soul?
Make your istighfar, salawats and do good deeds. Don't cry over spilt milk. Whatever is the past is the past. So don't think about the past, that's just shaitan playing with people. Just go forward and do good deeds, good actions. And nothing can be repairing of the past other than the good deeds of the future. And in those good deeds, and then meditate on the time right now. Every day is its own reality, and achieve that day's reality. And the shaitan makes us to want to think about the past and then worry about the future. Then we lost the day, and Allah has a gift in every day for the servant, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, how to protect against jealousy and sabotage?
How to protect against jealousy and sabotage? The same way we protect ourselves against all bad characteristics is that make our connection, do our salawats and don't show off. So hasad and jealousy is something that we put out and people respond. Now more than ever, everybody wants to put their entire life online, show everything that they do and achieved and got, and of course everyone's going to be jealous. And then they suffer the difficulty of that negative energy. If we're not a people that put things out and we feel within our heart just people are jealous, then show less. To people whom you think their eyes are not healthy, show even less to them. So that to protect yourself and be more humble around certain people. And again, everything else is based on our energy protection, that we're doing our zikrs, we do our tafakkur, we do our contemplation. The rest is in Allah's hands. So look at the shaykh himself, he's talking, I'm sure there's many people jealous, but it's not something we did to make people jealous, they're just jealous. That Allah has to defend us, otherwise what we can do more than, you know, than not speak or turn the camera off and speak just to make people to be happy because they don't want to see our face and become jealous of that. But we do our best effort, we do our salawats, we do all our awrads, our zikrs, and Allah is the best of those to protect. But the things that we do have in our hand, when we want to show off, then that risks the ability for people to become jealous and hasad, and that hasad and energy is then directed towards us. So I said, even when people have a home and they put something broken at the door, because people are coming into a home, maybe they don't have a home. So they're going to come and see everything and, you know, they say, mashallah, and put something broken at the door so that they look and the nazar goes to that broken item and not to them and to their home. So these are all our traditional ways. And then when we have the evil eye and people say, oh, this is a shirk, again completely misunderstood, the blue has a power. That when you put something blue, it attracts the eyes of people, because that's what we're trying to do. We understand the eyes of people are very dangerous, so we're trying to take their eyes and bring it here, bring it there, so that the eyes are not coming upon people. So we have those the Turkish eyes with the blue, and that's to use as a defense, as a protection for the nazar of people's eyes to go upon those things and not upon us and our persons and our family. So these are all the spiritual trainings that are given to the tariqas but lost in the last days. So it becomes like something strange. They're everywhere and now all of a sudden people woke up and say, why are they here? What is this? What is this? All of a sudden they became clever, or they woke up and all of a sudden became ignorant. How are those things everywhere? They're on every masjid, all these signs and ta'weezes and tariqah things. We're everywhere. So we didn't become smarter, we became dumber. We woke up one day and forgot all of these realities. Say, what is this thing here? And then everyone's wondering, yeah, what is that thing here? Take it down. What do you mean? For 1,000 years. But shaitan said, they forgot what this is, take it down, they don't know. And then before you know it, we took everything down as a protection and that made shaitan happy. And then people are sick, people are in difficulty, people are facing all sorts of horrific actions and energies. InshaAllah, protect us, guide us and inspire within our hearts these understandings and realities inshaAllah. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salaamun al mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.